Hello everyone and welcome to this presentation. My name is Olga Chukhno and I am a doctoral student at Mediterranean University of Reggio Calabria and Tampere University and an early stage researcher at the WEAR project. As you can see on this screen, this section is focused on European projects addressing the topics of interest of the conference, including wearable computing. Today, I would like to present our research paper, When Wearable Technology Meets Computing in Future Networks, A Road Ahead. This presentation will be in three parts. First, I will begin with an overview of a WEAR project by focusing on the project's financial information primary goals. Then, I will go on to highlight the actual discussion of the presented paper, namely background on wearables, communication, architecture, and computing aspects and challenges. To summarize this part, I will deliver a WEAR project fundamental principles to bridge the identified gap. At the end of the presentation, I will provide additional information that includes social media channels of the project and financial support statement. Now, let's move to the first part of the presentation. WEAR is a four-year Horizon 2020 Marie Skłodowska-Curie Innovative Training Network European Joint Doctorate, bringing together beneficiaries and partner organizations from Finland, Czech Republic, Italy, Romania, and Spain. The innovative training networks aim to train a new generation of early stage researchers able to face current and future challenges and convert knowledge and ideas into products and services for economic and social benefit. European Joint Doctorate have the objective of promoting international, intersectoral, and multi-interdisciplinary collaboration in doctoral level training in Europe through the creation of joint doctoral programs. European joint doctorates are composed of at least three beneficiaries established in different member states or associated countries entitled to deliver doctoral degrees. All early stage researchers are expected to actively participate in the achievement of the scientific and training objectives of WEAR. The training objectives are to educate, supervise, and train 15 early stage researchers for 3 years to achieve their PhD degrees, create and manage efficiently joint and double European PhD programs, and build a solid foundation for long-term structured joint PhD education in Europe in the Internet of Wearable Things. Create open source training material for educational purpose and publish and exploit research results and best practices in cooperation with the scientific community, industry, and general public. Have interactive participation in social media, promote career prospects of the researchers and expand the collaboration and the knowledge transfer also beyond our network. Foster multinational collaboration through regular network training events and cross-country secondments, as well as established and maintain long-term academic and industrial partnerships. The scientific objectives of WEAR are to create novel multi-layer knowledge for dynamic wearable networks in terms of localization, connectivity, privacy, and security. Identify vulnerabilities and offer innovative solutions in crowdsourced as well as cloud, edge, fog-based wearable architectures. Design and develop privacy-enhanced and location-aware wearable technologies. Devise new medium access control low latency algorithms and protocols for wearable communications, especially in the frequency bands of the future. Develop new open source software platforms for wearables and the Internet of Things. A powerful source for innovation and growth is when academia and industry work together on frontier research topic, as in our WEAR team. WEAR brings together 5 beneficiaries and 12 partner organizations from Finland, Czech Republic, Italy, Romania, and Spain. The overall strategy for making the WEAR European Joint Doctorate sustainable is the integration of the European joint doctorate into the ongoing doctoral programs at each partner, combined with the scientific reputation and highly quality of the participant beneficiaries. This is expected to facilitate creating excellence in wearable communication, computing, and localization. And that brings us to our next point, which is wearable technology. What are wearables? Wearables were involving independently in various directions, carrying different meanings, but mostly the same goals. A wearable is an item that can be worn. It is something such as a garment or a device that can be worn. It is a technology that is worn on the human body. Wearable technology, wearables, fashion technology, tech talks, or fashion electronics are smart electronic devices that can be incorporated into clothing or worn on the body as implants or accessories. The terms wearables, wearable devices, or also wearable technologies refer to electronic small and mobile devices or computers with wireless communication capability that are incorporated into gadgets, accessories, or clothes, which can be worn on the human body or even invasive versions such as microchips or smart tattoo. Compared to today's smartphones and tablets, the primary added value is that wearables can provide various monitoring and scanning features, including biofeedback or either sensory physiological functions such as biometry-related ones. Wearables can continuously measure such values, restricted by their battery constraints. They are convenient, seamless, portable, and can offer hands-free access to electronics. Despite that, wearable devices are getting tightly connected to the cloud system, creating additional load on today's networks. Users and enterprises are both tremendously affected by wearable device evolution. Wearable technology grows more extensive and widespread. The market of wearable devices is expected to reach over 40 billion euro per year in the next 5 years, with more than 1,500 billion euro by 2028. The proliferation of wearables is thus expected to increase steadily over the following decades, with a predominant transition from bracelets or sport trackers to more intelligent wearables. Further, wearable technology has a tremendous impact on a variety of industry verticals. And very shortly, smart wearables are expected to disrupt most business sectors such as industrial, health, and sport domains, and are going to reshape the industrial landscape as smart interconnected spaces fashion to address the open challenges in the field. The miniaturization trend, portability, wireless communication, energy efficient computing, and advanced display technology have been combined to create state-of-the-art smart devices. The patriarch of these devices, a smartphone, was released back in 1992. And intelligent media are now ready to lead the next great wave of innovation. Wearables are highly battery constrained devices, yet have the potential to change the world. It is expected that they will improve the technological and socio-cultural parts of our life. Moreover, wearables also have the strength to enhance well-established sectors, such as the smartphone industry and other handheld devices. The wearables we know today are mostly treated as smart by definition devices. People tend to forget that smartness hasn't always been defined by processing the data on chip, but rather by delivering a better experience for actual users. This slide shows the evolution of wearable technology. It started with the invention of spectacles around the 13th century by English friar Roger Bacon, and continued with the following inventions: the first pocket mechanical watch, abacus ring, wearable camera, portable radio, wristwatch, and virtual reality. In the mid 20th century period, there were inventions of wearable computers, entertainment set, smartwatch, and portable audio. Later on, in the late 21st century, the evolution brought AR headset, wearable input, location tracker, personal digital assistant, and mobile payment. Then, smartware, wireless headset, activity tracker, Roger Glass, and Android Wear have been invented in the early 21st century. Today, wearable technology could be identified as a separate niche of the Internet of Things, the Internet of Wearable Things. But modern wearables couldn't be imagined anymore without computational and communication enablers on the board. The connectivity between wearables with cloud is executed through the user's more power-independent smartphone gateway. All of those were forming a body area network. Wearable architectures significantly evolved over the last years, as shown on this slide. They started with the e-health systems, which were based on a few specialized devices worn by the patient, and on some storage and computational facility, either locally or remotely located on the internet. Hence, the first architecture of wearables is represented by a separate device. At the next step of the architecture revolution, wearables were connected to more powerful external device via wireless links. Then, wireless system have been replaced with wireless wearable systems. Due to the mass adoption of smartphones being a part of personal wearable cloud, manufacturers started to aim at other consumer wearables as supplements in a personal ecosystem rather than standalone device. It resulted in a new architecture where personal smartphones act as relays or gateways. Most fitness, sport, and healthcare wearable applications follow the fourth evolution step while sharing the data with applications installed on smartphones. This option implies several situations where wearables cannot connect to the network, such as the non-existence of a smartphone nearby, non-installed application on the smartphone, or outdated phone software. Considering such possible scenarios and the end users' ever-increasing expectations and needs, device manufacturers consider equipping wearables with short-range and long-range connectivity chipsets. Today, most wearable devices have at least two wireless interfaces on board. Given a sharper focus on wearable-targeted computing, we can already distinguish several potential candidate paradigms to broadly utilize smartphone gateway or cloud. These include essentially an unfamiliar device offloading via device-to-device links, multi-access edge computing, mist computing, mobile cloud computing, mobile ad hoc cloud computing, and many others. The paradigms vary tremendously, requiring heavy research from communication, hardware design, security, and privacy perspectives. Moreover, due to various applications, the developed computational offloading systems should also adapt and learn based on multiple factors and their dynamics, bringing even more complexity. As we move towards a more interconnected ecosystems, the volume of data generation will continue to grow, primarily pushed by the 5G technology and beyond, which provide continuous connectivity, faster download speed, greater network capacity, ultra-low latency, increased reliability and availability, and improved quality experience. However, not only technologies are developing, but also the problems that surround them. The main challenges related to wearable computing in future networks could be broadly divided into five groups associated with architecture, networking, data processing, hardware specific, and software. These include seamless switching between computing paradigms, migration of services or digital twins, energy efficient data gathering network, lack of network resources, low quality of service indicator, insufficient computing capabilities, discovery of inefficient computing resources, classification problems, anomaly detection, forecasting problems, aspect of artificial intelligence and machine learning on edge, lack of power and computational efficiency for machine learning and artificial intelligence enablers. Delegating wearable computing tasks is already being enabled by a series of existing communication computing technologies, including edge, fog, cloud computing, forthcoming 5G and 6G networks, and security solutions. However, almost nothing has been devoted to addressing the combination of the technologies mentioned, focusing on wearable devices with their stringent requirements compared to, for example, smartphones. Aware project aims to bridge this critical gap by exploring the following fundamental principles. The separation of network nodes into elements that ensure the operation of the user plane and control plane protocols, which significantly increases the flexibility in terms of scaling and deployment placement of individual components of network nodes. The implementation of network elements in the form of virtual network functions. The support for simultaneous access to centralized and local services, which allows implementing the concept of edge computing. The definition of a converged architecture that combines various types of access networks. The support for uniform algorithms and authentication procedures. The support for stateless network functions where the compute resource is separated from the storage resource. The roaming support with traffic routing both through the home routed and with the local breakout in the guest network. The exploration of the optimal displacement of network functions and network elements of the future infrastructure and remote computing. This brings us to the end of the main part of this presentation. To conclude, I would like to stress that AWARE has the following social media channels with the research and innovation activities related to smart wearables and wireless computing. Finally, we acknowledge funding from the European Union's Horizon 2020 Research and Innovation Program under the Marie-Sklodowska-Curie Grant Agreement. Thank you for your attention.